Hello everyone. We, the students of Vidyalankar Institute of Technology from the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, are presenting on the topic Integrating MANETs, WLAN and Cellular Networks under the guidance of Professor Dr. Saurabh Mehta. Under this topic, the contents which we are going to cover are: what is heterogeneous network, architecture of heterogeneous network, protocol stack, and integrated architectures. So what is heterogeneous network? It is basically integrating WLANs, WWANs, WMANs and cellular network together by observing their characteristics. So integrated heterogeneous environment enables a user to access any network depending upon the application and network availability. Heterogeneous network architecture. This is a heterogeneous communication network. It provides transparency and self-configuration. The basic components are mobile stations, base stations, and core IP network. Core IP network is a backbone of this architecture and it helps in access of internet. It is used for security purpose using AAA, that is authentication, authorization, and accounting. Here, base station and access points serve as a communication bridge for mobile station. At a given instant, mobile station can be within or outside the coverage area of base station and access point. The connection from the mobile stations to the base station and access point can be established by a single hop or multi-hop. Dual mode terminal protocol stack. This is a dual mode protocol stack as it integrates cellular and WLAN network together. This protocol stack consists of multiple layers. Some control planes such as mobility management and connection management can be added, which could eventually use information from several layers to implement their functionalities. Physical layer. If a mobile host is connected to a cellular network which is also within the coverage area of WLAN, then the network or the mobile host need to be able to switch from cellular to WLAN. Many power control techniques have been applied to limit the interface in cellular network and WLAN. Data link layer. It is divided as logical link control and MAC layer. The mobile host will be able to use TDMA and CDMA, that is time division multiple access and code division multiple access, while using cellular network, and CSMA and CA, that is carrier sense multiple access and collision avoidance, while using WLAN network. The data rate of cellular interface can reach up to 2.4 Mbps while using the cellular, and it can reach up to 11 Mbps while using WLAN. Although the integration of heterogeneous technologies will not be performed at link and MAC layers, these layers can provide useful information to upper layer. Security is also an important issue to be considered at the data link layer. Network layer. Network layer seems to be the most challenging as it integrates many technologies. However, integrated solutions rely on high processing and power capabilities of base stations and access points. In other words, the network layer has to discover the integrated topology and find the best routes, including number of hops, delay, throughput, and so on. Transport layer. The most used protocol in this layer is the TCP protocol, that is Transmission Control Protocol. So, the performance degradation of TCP protocol is the most important issue in the transport layer, as all the losses are assumed due to the congestion and factors such as channel errors and delay. The basic problem is how to maintain a TCP connection when a mobile host changes its IP address as it enters a new access network. Application layer. In a heterogeneous environment, the application should have only an access point to the transport layer and the network layer services, and all the underlying complexity should be hidden. The multiple access network available in a given location can also provide different kinds of application services to the user due to the multi-hop routing problem of end-to-end security arises. Heterogeneous network may suffer from various security threats. This may degrade the efficiency of packet relay, increase packet delivery latency, increase packet loss rate. Mobility and connection management. Mobility and connection management are the two control planes that provide topology discovery, detect available internet access, as well as support the handoffs. In a heterogeneous network, there are two types of handoffs, that is the horizontal handoff and vertical handoff. Horizontal handoff use the same technology, while the vertical handoff use the different technology. The horizontal handoff can be handled by the cellular network components at the link layer and the network layer. The mobile IP protocols IPv4 and IPv6 can be used to support macro and global mobility. In case of vertical handoffs, the two basic issues have to be considered are when to start the handoffs process, how to redirect the traffic between interfaces. So we can say no integrated solution exists to handle all the possible types of vertical handoffs in a heterogeneous environment. Integrated architectures. Several architectures and hybrid routing protocols have been proposed to integrate single hop and multi-hop routing. There are many architectures and routing protocols. A few of them will be discussed here, that are UCAN, Unified Cellular and Ad Hoc Network Architecture, One Hop and Two Hop Direct Transmission, Multiple Hop Cellular Network Architecture. So first, comparison between integrated architectures. Here we will be comparing Unified Cellular and Ad Hoc Network Architectures, One Hop, Two Hop Direct Transmission, Multiple Hop Cellular Network Architecture. So, the first comparison can be, this architecture considers dual mode mobile station with a cellular interface and WLAN interface, whereas this architecture in this hybrid protocols are introduced for integrating single hop and multiple hop operations in WLAN environment. And here, all the cells use the same data and control channels. When we see the second comparison, it says, this architecture can be applied in a scenario where all the nodes are assumed to be under the base station coverage. Here, BS is the base station. In this, we can say, several control messages are introduced for multi-hop operation as well as to allow mobile stations to discover their GNs, that is gateway networks. In this we can say the mobile stations and the base station data transmission power is reduced to half of the cell's radius to enable multiple simultaneous transmission using the same channel. So these are some of the references, that is ad hoc and sensor network book, second edition. And this is the websites from which we took protocol stack heterogeneous network as well as heterogeneous network architecture. So this was all about the heterogeneous network. Thank you.